First of all, let's start that last time I was here, I congratulate Sydney, you know, for it's important for them to win, so I repeat it, but no blame, no complaint about the referee, although it's a similar story. We lost in the last few minutes of the game. I think Sydney should think that there is a Gold Coast United on the competition, because every time we let them recover. But on the game, look, I don't know if you're aware, but we came today with around 9 out of the 15 players under 21 years old. You know, it's like all of them eligible to play youth team, youth league. And so, which means that we were lack of experience. And when we talk experience, it's not just you say it for the sake of the saying experience. It means that when you lead, you know how to protect your lead. When you 1-0 down, you know how to overcome it. You know how to stretch the time. You know how to speak with the referee. You know when to push and not to push. And that's all come to experience. So if you have a young team like ours, I think if the situation was reversed and Sydney have the 1-0 lead, you know what I mean? They wouldn't let it get away. And our story this season is that except one game, we're all the time losing by one goal. So either we're leading and we're losing, or either we 1-0 behind and we don't know how to come back. And that's it. So we, you know, if you want to look at it, we are a team of the future. We learn the trade. We're not such a bad side because we never get beaten by more than one goal. We're very competitive. But we're losing game and we're on the bottom of the ladder. You know, you compare us to a team like, Phoenix, they're now the new hit, you know. So all the players is 30 and over, and I have all the players 20 and under. So players that are 30 and over maybe is on the last leg. But they have the experience, they know how to win 1-0, 1-0, 1-0, and to get away with it, and that's why they are where they are. How the Phoenix will look like in 2 years' time, I don't know. Gold Coast United is a team of the future, so that's how you measure it. And the same, I don't know if you want to measure it in money-wise, so I think probably our forward line today, there are a few guys on 5,000 and a few guys on and one guy on 50,000, they're probably tens of the salary of Brett Emerton. So. You know, depends how you want to measure it, by kilo, by money, by years, by age, you know. So from all point of view, we don't have much to offer. So that's the one side of the story in general. For today game, you know, your season in down the drain or in the toilet. So that's what happened today. Ante Rozic was unbeaten in the air, and he was a tower of strength. And 10 minutes before the end, he had to have the toilet break. So I put Dylan McGowan and Hans Kazarin jump on the guy. I still believe that if Ante Rozic were there when the cross been done, we wouldn't have conceded. So Ante was in the toilet and the goal was scored. So that's a toilet season, you know. So whatever you want to look at it. What? Yeah, he wasn't sick. I don't know what's happened in the hotel because I also didn't feel the best and some few other guys. And at halftime he complained. I told him, Ante, I don't care. You know, you play. And then you see 10 minutes or whatever it happened, he was sitting on the ground. So I asked the physio, is he injured? He said, no. So I asked Ante, give me 10 minutes. He said, no, Miron, must rush to the toilet. And whoosh, off he gone. So I put young Dylan McGowan, come the cross. Kazarin, I don't know, a bit push, a bit strength. You know, I'm not blaming that the goal was illegal, but that was a duel between an experienced striker and a young defender. You see, the young defender, if there was Christian Ries or Ante Rozic, when the cross is coming, you already hold your ground. Don't let the striker go. He was, sorry about the expression, you know. You know, Dylan was flying in the air, you know, Kazarin just did everything in his power, and that's the goal. So one in the toilet and one ball in the back of the net. So, but that's our luck this season. I don't know, I thought, it's the same I thought about, you know, in the end, it's all balance from upstairs. Like, that's nothing to do with us, but I thought about Arnie when the ball of Adelaide from go traveled the line and then they scored 20 seconds after. So I thought, look at Arnie, you know, probably after the grand final, he thought it was the most unluckiest, the most cursed coach in the world, because who can lose grand final in the 190 minutes, you know? So now he get paid back. So you watch me next year, you know, how I'm winning every game that I don't need to win. You know, but it's, at the moment, you know, I'm laughing because I don't want to cry. So that's it. I'm on the border, you know. That's hard. You know, we came here twice. Twice we got beaten. I think Sydney got out of us 7 points, and and that's it. But again, Sydney, credit to them. I think they played well. They knew that they back to the wall. People think that they didn't play for the coach. What I saw today, they did play for the coach, and you know, for all the critics, I know when you're in big clubs, so everybody like to go. But I think they did a good job, you know. But from the other side, if City, with all these big names and all this experience, did a good job and still they have to beat us in the 88 minutes, also Gold Coast United with all the kids did, you know. I tell you, there was four guys today on $5,000 wages. Can you imagine a player from Sydney get $5,000 a week? He wouldn't even spit on you. So that's it. Got everything?
Yeah, we don't
have to ask. Any questions, guys? No, that's it. Can I go? Well done.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.